Fair enough. Now, we talked about the WEC belt. You held that. You were clearly defined as the best fighter in the world at 145 for a long time. What is the significance, Uriah, of getting a UFC belt? Not just financially, but personally. Is that different? Because at 145, when you held that belt, you were defined as the best guy in the world at that class. But it was a WEC belt. Now you're moving into the UFC. Is there a difference for you?
You know, really, if I were to break it down, no. But on a bigger level, you know, when I first started in this sport 7 years ago, my goal on my wall was to be a world champ in the UFC or the WEC or the UFC or Pride. And Pride is gone. The UFC is the place to be, and I've always wanted to have that belt. So I think, yeah, you know, deep down, you know, in my own head, I think, yeah, I want that UFC belt. It means a lot to me. But, you know, I don't really fight because of belts. I fight because of, you know, something that's inside me and something that I'm inspired by outside of material things. But to have the symbolism of the UFC belt and put it next to my WEC belt and the King of the Cage belt and the Gladiator Challenge belt and everything else is going to be in my vintage WEC belt that was before Zuffa. You know, it's an exciting thing for me, so I'm ready.
So, The Ultimate Fighter, your name's been tossed around since the merger as, like, you know, a guy who would be tailor-made for that show. Is that something you'd be excited to do? And if so, who would you like to coach against?
I would love to be the coach of The Ultimate Fighter, man. I think, you know, a prolonged, you know, opportunity to show people what I'm all about, some of the coaching skills and the coaching staff that I have would be great to have on the show as well. And you know, it'd be fun, man, to be a part of that. You know, I've watched it from the beginning, and it's been such a big part of mixed martial arts and what really turned the sport around for us and started making Zuffa and Dana and Lorenzo money instead of costing the money, which, you know, they were real troopers on going $40 million in debt. I don't know how many people would have done that, and I know that hardly any people have the ability to do that, but it would be great to be a part of that thing. And as far as who I coached against, there's been talk of Miguel Torres. I think also Dominic Cruz would be a good one. I mean, if he's still the champion at that point, he would be someone that would be interesting. You know, there's a little rivalry there already. And Miguel Torres is a crack up. He's a unique dude. So he'd be an interesting guy also, and that's a fight that people want to see. So probably either Cruz or Torres makes the most sense.
Yeah, listen, I think it would be a great vehicle to introduce the world to these lighter weight classes through you. And for me, Uriah, if I had a vote, if Dominic beat Scott, that'd be my vote, because I know there's a sincere rivalry there. I think that sells well. It plays well. He's fought Joseph, who I assume would probably be one of your coaches or at least be there on a regular basis. To me, that would make for great television. Miguel and you have a pretty good relationship overall, right?
Yeah, you know what? I mean, we don't communicate much anymore. I would say we don't have a bad relationship, but, I mean, like Scottie Jorgensen and I actually keep in contact quite a bit, but Miguel, I think Miguel's the type of guy that has kind of seen a fight with me coming for a long time, and I don't know how buddy-buddy he likes to be with people he's going to fight, which it makes a difficult thing, so I think he's been prepping for that, which is
right.
Fine with me. So, you know, that's a fight that I think is going to happen regardless. Same with the fight with Cruz is going to happen regardless. So, I mean, Scottie Jorgensen, I don't think that's a fight that's going to happen regardless. I mean, if we don't have to fight, we won't fight,
right.
You know.
Makes sense. So, Uriah, I want to ask your opinion on something, because it's got a little bit of debate, and I don't know too many fighters that know the fight game better than you do. The Brock Lesnar fight, and not just his fight with Kane, but his fight with Shane as well. I heard you make a comment once that a fighter has to accept getting hit. And it looks like Brock's not used to getting hit. Do you think he accepts that part of the game, or is something missing in his training? Because it looks like when he gets hit, like he's never been hit before.
I would say that I'm not sure how much it's actually missing, but he hasn't had enough of it, and that's a ton of straight sparring. You know, when we train, and our training camp is extremely high level and really thought out. We have a bunch of different trainers in a bunch of different areas. But, you know, even 2.5 years ago, when my head trainer, Master Tong, came in and started working with the team, he just kept saying, hey, no scared. You know, you can't be scared. You can't be scared. And he would let us hit him in the face over and over again. And we all thought he was crazy. I mean, he would literally let us unload on his face, and he's kind of a genetic freak as it is, and he's had 200-plus Muay Thai fights and boxing fights and MMA fights and stuff like that. But the bottom line and the lesson he was trying to show us without speaking any English is, dude, getting hit is not the coolest thing to have done to you, but it's not that big of a deal, and it takes a ton of sparring and some great defense and a knowledge of what it's like to get hit in order to be able to get used to it. So I heard rumors that Lesnar wasn't letting guys punch him in the face during sparring, and I don't know how many sparring sessions he did where he wasn't able to use takedowns, but he needs to do some straight sparring. Even at this point, we spar twice a week, straight boxing. We spar a couple times a week with just kickboxing, and you know, transition that into MMA at the end of a practice or sometimes, you know, mix it all together in situations, but you got to really get used to that. I mean, the worst punches are the ones you don't see coming, and if you don't see any punches coming because you're ducking your head, that's the worst case scenario. So I think he's got room for improvement. I think he's still going to be a great fighter as long as he decides to do that, but he needs to get in there and accept, hey, I'm going to get hit, and there's guys that are better than punching than I am, and he just needs to put in the time like everyone else.
So if I'm hearing you, Uriah, you can get comfortable with getting hit through experience, even if your natural reaction to getting hit is to kind of turn and run away or back away or whatever the case is.
Oh, 100%. You know, and we've all been there where Lesnar was. I mean, unfortunately for him, it was me, you know, 5 years ago that was as comfortable as he was, and I just worked on it over time. And but with a great training camp, you know, I've got guys like T.J. Dillashaw, who's been here 11 months, and Chad Mendes has been here 2 years, and Micah Ferguson, who's a wrestler who's not used to getting punched. All these guys aren't used to getting punched, and with the right techniques and the right experience and the right nurturing environment to getting hit, if there is such a thing, I mean, it's a pretty simple thing. Time when people were saying, you know, a speech that I gave on a question and answer about not liking Lesnar, and I just kind of didn't like the fact that he had so many eyes on him and had so much influence in the sport, and he came off so bad for the sport after his fight with Mir, but I think he's grown a lot. And, man, I would be willing to help him out if he was really into learning. You know, I think there's some things that just simple things that would help him out a lot. And I mean, he shouldn't be losing to guys that are 40 pounds lighter than him.
Right. Well, the only thing is, Uriah, if you're going to help him, you're going to have to stand on a chair or something, you know?
Yeah, I'll help with my brain. I won't be trying to go punch for punch with that guy, that's for sure.
That's probably a good idea.